with the international source of finance. International source of finance. So international source of finance is here. This with the effect of internet, with the effect of liberalization, with the effect of globalization. In 1991, India opened up their gates. India opened up their gates towards the foreign countries to invest in India. So before that there was several restrictions were there, but in 1991, so our economy was opened up. So now foreign investors can come here and they can invest their money in the industries. So that is the effect, with the effect of globalization and liberalization has gave. So they have initiated to enter different types of source of finance. So now with that effect international source of financial institutions have come up. So there are four types of financial institutions which entered in India. So first we'll learn about the first one, American Depository Receipt. So these ADRs are very famous in India, very famous, very popular across the world. So here It was issued by US bank. So here ADRs are mainly issued by the US bank firstly, and it was firstly introduced by the JP Morgan. So these are the first company, they have introduced these American Depository Receipts for the financial assistancement of financial institutions. So here they are the first person to introduce this American Depository Receipts, ADRs. So in the year of 1927, the majority of ADRs range from $10 to $100 per share. So here they will range the price of ADR will range from $10 to $100 per share. $10 to $100 per share. So that is what their main range of price actually. So here there are some companies. They mainly release this ADRs. Those are BNY Mellon and JP Morgan, Citigroup and Debtsert Bank. So these are the institutions they will issue this American Depository Receipts. So here American Depository Receipts. So it is basically negotiable instrument, and not only that, here which represents the specific number of shares in a foreign stock that is traded in US exchange. Specific shares of foreign shares that is traded in a US exchange. So here Nasdaq is the US stock exchange. So here the basic foreign trades which are traded in that stock exchange is called as ADRs. So it is called a negotiable instrument. It is called as a negotiable instruments, and these are the companies they mainly issue ADRs. So next we'll move forward to the global depository receipts. So here global depository receipts, GDRs. So here these are very similar to the ADRs, and these GDRs also mainly listed in the Nasdaq and some other Luxembourg, in some other stock exchanges also, in world stock exchanges these GDRs are listed. So here GDR is like a bank certificate issued in more than one country for shares in foreign country. So it is like a bank certificate. It is like a bank certificate which can be issued more than one country for the shares in the foreign country. So it is if we want a shares in foreign country, we have to get that GDRs. So here All over the world, we have more than 900 in GDRs, 900 in global depository receipts are there. So it doesn't have a voting rights. It doesn't have a voting right, and it can be converted. It can be converted into equity shares also. So, but it doesn't have any voting right. So like us, like ADRs also doesn't have a voting right. Doesn't have a voting right. And GDR also doesn't have a voting right. So these are main institutions, that is ADR and GDR.